Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Nate Reviews. Today is the 12th day of Christmas, so Merry Christmas, everybody. But so, this episode I'm going to be reviewing Ernest Saves Christmas. And, beginning of the movie, we see this guy. He looks like somebody that has to do with Christmas. I'm not going to name names yet, but anyway, I knew it right off the bat that he was that. I'm going to do you a spoiler. It's a spoiler alert. He's Santa Claus. So anyway, Santa Claus, I knew it when I first saw him, it was too obvious. But then, you see Santa Claus, like, takes some cab and goes somewhere, and like, the cab driver is Ernest. But Ernest, keeps driving real crazy and hurting a bunch of people, and acting really crazy. I don't understand. I can't quite describe how Ernest acts. His acting is it's kind of unique in that he just I don't know. Like, he's for starters, he's like really animated the whole movie, and then we also see like he's like. Extremely fast-paced in his talking. I don't know how to describe it, but it's just like really fast. So, anyway, next we see there's these two guys that are working in, I'm not sure what this job is exactly. Are they UPS workers or what? But their jobs are basically like, I guess, storehouse workers. Because they gotta just watch these boxes and they keep acting really weird. This guy keeps making his eyes move from side to side really fast. I'm not sure how zoomed in this is, but this is basically how it does it. A lot faster than that. I don't think that was very fast. I think that's probably better. And it might not be the camera might not be zoomed in enough for you to see, so I don't know. But anyway, I think he was from something. I've seen him before, though. I don't know what it was, but I'm convinced I saw him in a movie before this. Anyway, Ernest eventually figures out that Santa Claus really is Santa Claus, and he finds this teenage girl. Yeah, she's kind of just like, I'm not even sure why she's there, to be totally honest. She's kind of his side plot to fill in the movie. But basically, her entire story arc is that she ran away from home because she feels like she's been ignored, which we know because Santa Claus just tells us in one scene. Basically, her entire character is poorly written. That's sort of what. Eventually, she steals the Santa Claus sack of presents, which are, like, the presents are turned from these orb things. Also, in the sack, you can hear, like, people screaming, which is kind of creepy. not exactly sure why that's there, but my brother mentioned it, and he's the one behind the camera right now, so. He didn't even react to that. So, next we see... the cop but Santa Claus sack gets stolen by her, and then by the way, there's also a story about him going to jail, but I'm just not gonna mention that. This is once again just a filler crap, unimportant to the story. But anyway, they keep turning back to these storehouse workers, which they're only relevant for like a little bit in the plot, so I'm not exactly sure why. But anyway, eventually we find out that Santa Claus is going to make this new guy Santa Claus, and it's some random actor. Why he can't just make Ernest Santa Claus, I'm not sure, but he wants specifically this guy to be Santa Claus, Joe. So, I don't even think they mentioned his last name in the movie, but he's Joe. So Joe doesn't want to be Santa Claus because he doesn't believe Santa Claus when he tells him that he's got to be the new Santa Claus. Anyway, Ernest, just keeps helping Santa Claus, and then eventually he helps him get his reindeer back, and then Joe becomes a new Santa Claus because he eventually finds out he's real when he sees Ernest flying the reindeer. Space and everything, which is, I don't know. The movie's really confusing. That's why I mentioned it earlier. I'm still trying to digest what happened, really, because everything happened so fast. But Joe, at the end of the movie is where Joe becomes Santa Claus, and then he flies off with the reindeer and the presents that the girl, when she felt bad in return. And yeah, that's the end of the movie. So basically, the plot is kind of just a bunch of stuff happens. And that's it. That's the whole story. It's not really... I'm not really sure why the plot is designed the way that it is. It feels like most of it is just filler. Yeah. I don't think it's necessarily a bad movie, it's just a comedy movie that you gotta be able to keep up with. So, overall, if you just want to have like a simple plot that you can follow from start to finish, some jokes to laugh at along the way, this probably isn't the movie for you. But if you want to have a unique experience and laugh at complete absurdity, then this is probably a good film. That furnace is pretty loud, so I'm going to be trying to speak up, but that's pretty much the view anyway. So, have a Merry Christmas. Think about it.